double bender install on a 6-saddle bridge. The guitar is set up with 2 rolling benders. The B bender is set up using the bender puller, and the G bender is operated as a palm bender. Notice the different heights. The B bender is set up low, the G bender is set up high, so you can operate the G bender without hitting the B bender. Here's an example.
Absolutely think this is a fantastic guitar. It's a guitar that Joe Glazer built for me. Back levers on the back of this guitar. I'll give you a better shot of it. There they are. The G string is holding, the weight of the guitar is on this, so there's a spring on it. And when I push the guitar down and activate that lever, it does the G string. And the B is got what looks like a little keychain that's hooked up to a belt loop on my pants. And this one is an out move. And so you can get them both going at the same time. It's almost like a box position here with the benders. You know, you got down, got out. Got both of those going at the same time. It's down and out. It's a diagonal push, down and away. Gotta kind of be careful on your angle so you don't. You can do a little contrary motion. Got a little unison going on here. Now I'm gonna go from the down position with the G already down, and I'm going to go up and away. Pretty cool, right?
Change it around a little bit, but the B bender, you know, obviously you can do all the bender licks. You know. But having the Bigsby and the B string not going through it, it opens up a bunch of other cool things. Like you can use the Bigsby to drop, say, the G string and get pedal steel type licks, or the D string if you're just playing the B and the D. So, see what I'm saying? You know, so you're going from your 1 to your 5. Down to the 4. And then... like... 5 chord to the 1 chord. Just by touching the G string and the B string and coming down with it, or bending it up, and then dropping the G string. I went a little too far. But there's just a whole world of possibilities opened up for me when I did this.